So in this video, I'm talking about the difference between the generated potential and action potentials from receptor to the nerve fiber. The nerve fiber being shown here with the nodes of ranvier, and the tip of the nerve fiber, which is myelinated and been encircled with the peceni and corpuscle with the different layers. And when we applied the stimulus, which is shown as an arrow mark, the right side, the response is being shown here, and with double strength, triple strength, and the four times strength of the stimulus would produce as the action potential. The initial the depolarization, non-propagating depolarization in the peceni and corpuscle is known as excitatory postsynaptic potential, or otherwise called generator potential, which is exclusively produced in the receptor itself, the sensory receptor itself. And once the threshold is reached around the 10 millivolts, so that triggers the action potential in the first node of ranvier in the sensory fiber, which are emerging from the receptor, particular receptor. So that is how the generator potential and action potential are entirely different, and generated potential produced in the receptor itself, the vicinity of the receptor, and the action potential is produced in the first node of ranvier, and therefore for propagates towards the brain. So the process of the action potential in the node of ranvier is absolutely follows the all or none law of the sensory fiber. And the second aspect of this video is the law of specific nerve energies. And these energies were studied in 1835 by the Muller, John Muller. And it says, wherever you stimulate along with the pathway from the sensory fiber to the brain, so you feel the same response, particular stimulus being elicited at the entire part.